Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and last week I did an update video about different apps that Apple updated, as well as other companies also. And so I thought I'd cover a similar thing this week with different apps that have been updated on iPhone, iPad, and Mac for the third week of April 2022. Now, the first thing that's been updated today is Maps. Maps get some major updates in different cities across the United States and also around the world. The first one is, you can see here is Chicago. We now have bicycle or cycling directions in many different cities in the Midwest of the United States, including Chicago, Detroit, Indianapolis, Cleveland, Columbus, Cincinnati, and Charleston. And you can see this here, bike lanes and shared roads, and it gives more information about that. They've also updated maps with more detailed driving directions and more in Germany and Singapore. So you should have updated driving directions in places like Berlin and other major cities, as well as Singapore also. So those have been updated across Apple Maps if you're using that. I think if you try Apple Maps with directions, many people like this a little bit more than Google Maps. Plus it doesn't use all of your data and information. And so let me know if you're seeing the update and what it's like for you and what you think of it in the comments below. Apple Fitness gets some major updates this week as well for Earth Day and also International Dance Day. So if we go into Fitness, go to Fitness Plus, you can see here's some new dances with artist spotlights. So Dance with LaShawn, music by ABBA or ABBA. And you can see there's more here. Now this is for International Dance Day on April 25th, and they'll have a limited edition award and also all of these new workouts. There'll be a dance badge, animated stickers, and they can be earned by completing any 20-minute dance workout or more. There will also be Get Into the Groove dance sections on Fitness Plus on April 25th. Now also, I mentioned some of this before, but to celebrate Earth Day tomorrow, there will also be an award badge that requires you just to do a 30-minute workout. It can be any 30-minute workout, from a walk to a run or anything else. There's also a new time to work out with Dr. Jane Goodall. So if we scroll down here, you have a new time to walk workout. This is for Earth Day. And you also have new meditations inspired by nature, you can see here. And then also a time to run this week at Yosemite National Park. So you'll see that here as well. So you'll have that, as well as that new badge, like I mentioned, that requires a 30-minute workout. Starting soon, Apple will release communication safety updates for kids around the world in different areas. Now, communication safety has to be enabled by the parent or guardian, and it allows you to have the phone check for sensitive photos using the neural engine. It's not sent to Apple, and what it does is actually warn your child if it thinks maybe a photo contains some explicit content. So it will warn them, and then they can go through that, and you can see more information here where you could say block the contact, message someone, or other ways to get help. So that's something they've updated. This is actually coming soon to Canada, the UK, Australia, and New Zealand. And so you actually have to enable this though. So if you don't want it enabled, you don't have to, but if you go to settings and then you go to screen time, and under screen time for your child or whoever you're a guardian of, you can see communication safety here. Tap on this and it says check for sensitive photos, and then it gives more information about it and view child safety resources. So you can turn that on or off. It's up to you. You should start seeing it in those areas soon. WhatsApp Business is now working on a new subscription plan that will allow up to 10 linked devices. So you could have different linked devices and add those multiple devices so different people in your business can talk to one another, maybe to a customer in the same chat. So that's something that should be coming in the future. And also, if you're a WhatsApp beta tester, they're rolling out some new reaction features I mentioned last week. You can expect the public release soon, but if you're a beta tester for WhatsApp, you may be seeing those already. Telegram gets some major updates this week as well. That's something I use a lot. I actually have a Telegram channel where people chat about Apple and other things as well, and it's linked in the description. It received version 8.7 with some significant updates to notification sounds and much more. So you can see there's custom notification sounds, custom mute durations, new auto delete menu and profiles, replies in forwarded messages, shop bots, instantly configure bot admins, and then also improved message translation. You can see all of the details on the Telegram page on the App Store, and it shows you all of the different things they've changed. So press and hold an audio file in chats to add them to your list of sounds, or use upload sound in the notification menu. Then you can change that to your notification sound. So that's something they've updated in Telegram, as many people are moving away from WhatsApp and either using Telegram or Signal. So it's great to see them updating this as well. Now, Google released a new app this past week to help you switch to Android. This was released by Google and it's on your iPhone. So if you want to try out Android, maybe you want to use it as a secondary device, you can move everything over, accept the policy, hit start, and then you'll just use your camera to scan a QR code on your Android device and get started. So you can move everything across, similar to what you do when you set up an iPhone for the first time. So that's something that we'll see be very helpful for those that want to either maybe move everything to Android or just have a secondary device as well. Now, if you're not using Apple Music or Spotify or another music service, but instead you're using Tidal for lossless music, it's now been updated so that you can use Siri with it to maybe play a song, an album, or a playlist. So that's something that we've had on different services for a while that Tidal has finally added. Now, if you use Instagram, they've updated this as well with some new features that some people have had for a while. So if we go into Instagram and maybe you're sharing content to Reels or something else, you can now tag products. Everyone can tag products. So maybe you are showing AirPods and you want to tag Apple or tag maybe just Apple AirPods. You can do that here. There's also enhancements to tag people as well. So that's something that's been updated. And then Instagram will now better rank original posts over reposted content from, say, maybe TikTok. So they're really encouraging you not to post something from another site and create original content on Instagram. So they're actually prioritizing that now. Now on the Mac, there's some updates as well. Last week, we had a big update to Final Cut Pro, Motion, and Compressor that Apple makes, along with iMovie and some iWork apps as well. However, not everyone uses Final Cut Pro. In fact, a lot of people use Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve. And Blackmagic Design this week released DaVinci Resolve 18 in beta. You can download it free and try it out. You can see the beta here. There's also still the 17 version, but with beta 18 or DaVinci Resolve 18 beta, there's some major enhancements, especially if you have an M1 Ultra. There's some enhancements there, just like Apple updated last time. There's also cloud collaboration updates and color updates with things such as automatic depth maps, which look really great, intuitive object masks. You can see track moving with warped surfaces, updated Resolve FX Beauty, and much more. So you can see a bunch of different enhancements with everything from Fusion to Fairlight, with different audio files, with automatic binaural rendering, and much more. So these are some great tools to see updated, and then also Neural Engine Acceleration on Apple's M1 and M1 Pro models. It says it gives up to 300% speed improvements in dozens of tools that rely on accurate automated analysis of motion and content such as Smart Reframe, Speed Warp, or Superscale, and then HDR monitoring on a laptop, and much more. So these are really great, and it's a great alternative. If you don't want to use Final Cut Pro, you can use it for free, of course, and there's some enhancements if you buy the studio version. So pretty great updates, and then up to 30 times faster playback on multicam 8K timelines on an M1 Ultra. So some huge improvements with that. Now also, many people don't use Safari or Chrome, but they're using Brave or some other browser. Brave gets an enhancement this time around to avoid AMP on Google. So there's actually a new feature. Google AMP is getting an update anyway in the future, but to avoid issues or add additional security, Brave has said, where possible, dAMP will rewrite links and URLs to prevent users from visiting AMP pages altogether. And in cases where that is not possible, Brave will watch as pages are being fetched and redirect users away from AMP pages before the page is even rendered, preventing AMP or Google code from being loaded and executed. So that's something that is called dAMP that's been added to the Brave browser and is available now if you're updated. So that's something that it's really great. If you're concerned about that, it's available now and updated with Brave. Now, if you didn't see the video from earlier this week, Apple also released iOS 15.5 Beta 2, along with iPadOS 15.5 Beta 2, Mac, Apple Watch, tvOS, and HomePodOS betas as well. So I mentioned everything that's new in the iOS and iPadOS update. And as far as a public release, I'm surprised we don't have one yet with iOS 15.4.2. I would expect Apple to release some sort of public version before we see a final release of iOS 15.5. Apple the other week stopped signing iOS 15.4, which means you can no longer downgrade to it. And typically when they do that, within 2 to 3 weeks, we'll see a public release as well to fix maybe some bugs and security issues. So we could expect that either maybe today or tomorrow, but most likely probably next week, with iOS 15.5 beta 3 and final versions coming out the following week. then subsequent betas after that, with a final release of iOS 15.5 probably around WWDC on June 6th, or maybe a little bit before. That's typically what Apple does, and then we'll have iOS 15 betas all the way until September, along with iOS 16 betas starting on June 6th. So iOS 16 beta 1 on June 6th, probably beta 2 on June 20th or a little bit later, and then the final version in mid to late September like they normally do. So that's what we can expect this time around. So that's everything as far as iOS updates and this past week's app updates. If there's anything else you'd want me to cover, whether that be popular games or different things with updates there as well, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.